Hi guys, it seems the activity in the one crater that is left from the eruption is declining. There's an interesting update from the Met Office that I want to show you. But boy, I think this eruption is going out with a bang if it's still declining, if that's really true. Because what it has done yesterday was really, really mean, because you couldn't see it coming. If you see the pictures, there's the fence walls of Swartzenge, and the Swartzenge power plant is under threat, because you see that the lava carpet has gotten higher and higher and higher and higher, layers of lava flowing on top of each other. But it was all looking dark, black, so you couldn't see any lava flow, anything yellow, orange, reddish coming that was flowing. So you, if you see a lava flow come, you can react in time. So on Tuesday, it has crawled over and on top of the defense wall, the black stuff, it was lifting up and then slowly coming over. So that wasn't too much of a problem. That was basically similar to what had happened at the Grindavik defense walls at the northeastern area of the defense wall. So that's nothing that would be like fast flowing. But what happened yesterday is there must have formed a lava tube underneath this black lava carpet. So there was a pathway for fresh red liquid lava to sneak up on the defense wall, basically unseen. And then all of a sudden it comes up to the defense wall, and then a hole opens and the fresh red glowing lava flows over the defense wall, and then really did flow inside Swartzenge. So it wasn't really creeping like it did last Tuesday. It was really flowing in there. And then at first they tried to spray it with water to cool it down. Then they had the dozers there, but it was advancing, and then it opened up one spot, second spot, third spot, a little bit further away from each other, so that, you know, where would they go? Which one would they fight? They had about 35 men out there. The problem was, and if you see the pictures, maybe this makes it clear, the one that is furthest away, since this was sending lava flow and then the other ones were sending lava flow, the other ones were cutting off access to the other one that was basically more to the east. So they couldn't do much with dozers there or cooling. So they had to retreat, so to speak. And then they made the decision, wow, gosh, we need to basically build another wall or somehow, right? So they started doing this with full force to keep the lava in check there. But basically, if you see the picture, I mean, there's Silingerfell, that Mount Silingerfell, and then there's the existing defense wall, and then they're building this new area of the defense wall, and they're basically creating a pond there for the lava, which works at the moment. But should there be another influx of more lava and this fills up, then it'll go over that defense wall again. So the Swartzenge power plant, the main buildings are about a kilometer away. So that's less than a mile, a little more than half a mile from Silingerfell. But what you also see in these webcam pictures of RUV is that the infrastructure that belongs to the power plant, these pipes that are above ground that you see there, the red pipes and stuff like this, that is in direct proximity. So that doesn't look like it's a kilometer away. This just looks like it's 50, 100 meters away from where the lava is already flowing. So what an effort. I think they had quite a few moments of panic. And I mean, the only good thing is that this morning the civil defense was flying over the crater, and the Met Office has also released a picture. It looks like in the crater it is dying down. Thorvaldur Thorvaldsen has said in the morning he doesn't see any activity in the crater anymore. That's not 100% accurate. You still see that there is red stuff in there, so there's still some magma coming to the surface, but it is slowing down. So they have also released an audiograph, so to speak. So they had a measuring station in Grindavik that measures the noise that this eruption is making. And then you can see that graph is gradually going down. So the less noise it makes, it seems the less magma is coming to the surface. So that's their indication that this eruption might be dying down. But the lava is still pushing against the dikes. And you can see on these pictures where the work groups are building defense walls inside Sortsanghi. And these three wall breaches are the biggest that they have ever had. And there was an engineer who leads this civil defense infrastructure group that is there to assess the situation and to find ways, if there are ways, to make sure to protect the power plants. So right now they have two temporary dams, walls that they have rushed to put up that hold back the flow for now. And that engineer is saying the main goal of everything that they're doing is to protect the power plant, the geothermal power plant in Sortsanghi. So he says, quote, "So we're racing to try and keep up with the lava flow. Fortunately, there is a slowdown in the flow of lava, but that can change again at short notice." There he is correct. He says, "So we continue to try to contain it there, but we will see what happens." So he doesn't sound 100% optimistic that they can save the power plant. And then they ask him, well, let's say the current eruption ends, and then there's another eruption because the land keeps rising again underneath Sortsanghi. So it looks like the same events will repeat. We will see another event. That's what it looks like right now. And then he says, well, if there is another eruption, sometimes older lava often acts as a defense against newer lava flows. However, they closely need to monitor future developments should they arise. Yeah, because the current lava carpet around the current eruption has built up quite high, probably 16, 20 meters in some areas, even higher. So depending on where a potential new eruption might be, they might act as a natural defense wall. But who knows, right? If there's a new location for the eruption, things can change. And what was very interesting to watch, I watched this during the night, I was up till 5:30 a.m. watching this, is that there were these three breaches in the defense wall that you see here. And then it was building a new lava carpet inside of Sortsanghi. And in my opinion, it was spreading quite fast, which was forcing these machines to retreat. And then you could see basically in the middle of that new carpet, it was like steam was rising from the flowing lava, but this was a little lighter than the other stuff. It was really like yellow, orange steam, as if something was burning underneath. I still don't exactly know what it was. Did they start to build a new defense wall there and that rock was melting? Something like this, but it looked kind of apocalyptic to see this island of yellow steam working its way there. And right now we still have work groups at Sillingerfell, and they have been working there since yesterday nonstop to stop that progress of that lava. Because it's really, and if you look at what RUV writes here, and they have really a good picture of that lava tube here, is again what I said, it's kind of evil how it comes out of the ground right where the defense wall is. Was sneaking up on the defense wall, right? You couldn't see it, and then poof, it starts flowing quite fast. If you see it creeping up like it did in the past, you have time to react, push it back. But this was too fast to really reply to it in a perfect way, so to speak. And so if you scroll down their website even more, you see this lava carpet, how far it has spread. And then you see on the left bottom, you see the defense wall that they have put up. But I have to say, the lava carpet has built up there quite high already at the new defense wall. So should there be, just in my opinion, a little bit more lava flow, it goes over that defense wall as well. So I don't think they're anywhere near being out of the woods, only if the eruption stops. That could come to their advantage. And I mean, you see here the steam and the lava flow, and then on the right side, this little guy standing there, these heroes, these Fraggles, they keep building. How tiny he is with his water pump compared to the force of this volcano and what it's doing, right? So these tiny little efforts to cool it down, they don't have the right equipment. They only ordered the pumps, bigger pumps, to put more pressure, to pump more water to that lava last week. And they were talking about this last November already, as early as last November, because then they became aware Grindavik might be threatened, right? They were worried about Grindavik. And there is experience with this. 1973, Investmannaeyjar on the Western Island. They were diverting lava with cooling it so they could save their ports. So they had inferior technology to what's available today. But the problem is, if the authorities, the politicians, if they don't react proactive enough. I mean, I don't blame them if they didn't do this in November. Maybe if they didn't do it in December because they thought maybe this will end. But then the next eruption in January that came so close in Grindavik burned down the homes, at least then they should have ordered the cooling equipment. Or were they so confident that the defense walls would be the glory grail that would protect them? Because that doesn't make much sense, because in January there was a fissure opening inside the defense walls and the lava was flowing towards the houses, burning down three houses. So if they had had cooling equipment at that time, and they could have prevented more maybe, but you know, they were lucky that the eruption ended. So they did not have to divert the lava inside Grindavik. But you know, they should have ordered that earlier. That's my opinion. Let me know what you think. But it's really, these pictures show how much new lava has flowed into that Svartsengi area and how fast, even inside, it is gaining height. And that's the problem, because should the lava creep over the next, these temporary new defense walls, what then? Build another one? Where would you divert it? Because there's Mount Thorbjørn, there's the Lingerfell, there's the power plant, there's the old defense wall. So you have to kind of send it towards Grindavik or Vegur and down to Grindavik. That's the only way out of this. But then it's in Grindavik where the defense walls are already threatened by that high lava carpet that reached heights higher than the defense walls already. So they had to increase the defense walls, but you can only increase the defense walls so much. So they kind of have reached their limits too. They can widen them, but that doesn't help you if it's creeping over them. So they're making it very, very clear what they're saying. They're saying, and the Icelandic television, radio station, newspaper, RUV has made an interview with the personnel that's responsible for trying to keep this lava in check. And they're saying, we are in a race against time and the lava is not cooperating with us. So you have to make that clear in your head what that really means. So work groups are racing against time at the defense wall in this Sillingerfell area while the lava is still slowly pouring over the defense walls towards the power plant in Svartsengi. And it cannot be said that the defense walls that are trying to shelter the power plant have been given a break today, after what happened in the night, these breaches. And there are reports that it's been like three breaches or even four breaches of that lava that was creeping over the defense walls. So one official is quoted saying, today we are trying to shift our focus from saving ourselves from a corner to moving on to the main goal, which is to continue raising the main defense wall, L1. That's the name of this main defense wall around Svartsengi in the northern part. And this is the one that's before Silinger fell. And at the same time, they have to fight off these lava flows that are heavily coming over the defense walls. That's what an engineer of the company Verkis is saying. They're doing the excavation and the dozers. They're basically doing all the work at Svartsengi to protect Svartsengi right now. So they're having all their heavy equipment and machinery there to do that. And they say we're delaying the lava from coming here, coming in here, and more lava coming over the edge. And they say we've been here since 2 in the morning and we've managed to keep it under control here. So there were always new tongues sticking out there, and we've managed to keep them under control with spraying them and cooling them. And you can see they have laid these hoses over quite a distance. And they're saying that they have seen 4 lava tongues, so they must know. On the live cams, it looked like 3. And they say by cooling these lava tongues down, they only have 2 left as of right now, it seems. The 2 ones that are left are progressing very slowly, and right now they don't think it's immediate danger. So what they're doing right now is, when you look at the spraying and you look at all these hoses, the fire brigade is spraying 9,600 liters per minute onto the lava tongues that have been creeping over the defense wall. But as I said, as a backup, they're also building this other defense wall inside Svartsengi. And all this is only done to protect the power plant in Svartsengi. And they have released a map with the red line there. You can see where they're building this new defense wall. And as I just said, yeah, it can take some lava, but also this can create another lava pool, because this is only a small area and the lava can't get anywhere. So if there is another larger flow, it will flow over this defense wall as well. And then you see the road Grindavikovegua. So then the only thing they can do is divert it south towards Grindavik if they want to divert it from the western parts. And they're admitting that last night, they say it didn't look very good when one breach was opening after the other. They say they also need to preserve the defense wall and keep it in place if there should be another eruption after this one. And it's very likely that there is, because the land is rising again. So that's why they have decided to raise the defense wall at Silingerfell by several meters. Of course, this requires a lot of material. Right now, they have to use what they have there, because otherwise they need to truck it there, and that takes a lot of time too. So this undergoing is going well, but they're also saying we are in a race against time and this lava is not cooperating with us. But the latest news is that the eruption is decreasing slowly, and they say this will help us in the fight. But they're also saying, even if the lava flow from the crater is decreasing, but it's still so big, and there's such a big difference in elevation up here, that it's going to take a few days for that material to hopefully start making its way down here. So she says we have to be on guard for a few days or even 2 weeks. And once the lava goes over these defense walls, it slopes down towards the power plant. So guys, this was a quick update about that situation there. That volcano keeps us busy, and it comes up with always a new way to like get our attention. So this was kind of a surprise what happened there. We knew that something like this could happen again, because that lava lake at Silingerfell was refilling. A breach of the wall in that lava lake, like a dam breaking, was causing that rapid lava flow last Tuesday that already did creep over the defense wall. So something like this happened again, but it was flowing unnoticed underneath that lava carpet. So now we have to see what time will tell us if this crater will stop erupting. Then they have a good chance that the power plant is safe for now. But what's going on underneath the power plant is still a point of concern. There is this shallow magma chamber that keeps rising and expanding again. So we will have to wait and see. Thanks for watching, guys. Check out my other videos about Campi Flegrei in Italy. That's rumbling quite on a concerning level. And I hope to see you very soon. Please don't forget to like and share this video. Subscribe if you're new here so that we can see each other on a regular basis. That would be great. Thanks for all your comments, your coffees, your support, your supers. You're wonderful. It's greatly appreciated. If you want to support my channel, there's a link in the description of this video to my buymeacoffee.com site. And I'm just having one, and I hope to see you soon. I'm out of here. Thank you, guys. Bye-bye.